Virgos, welcome to Ascending Spiritually. My name is Dee. This is going to be for August 16th through the 21st. Keep in mind that this is a general reading. That means not all the messages are going to resonate. If you want something tailored specifically for you, the link to book that reading is in the description box below, or you can go to directly at ascendingspiritually.com. So let's see what you guys can expect. This could resonate vice versa. So if I'm not picking up on you, it's somebody else that's around you. And the gender of the cards don't matter. So first card that we have is Nine of Pentacles, the Lovers, Ten of Cups, Queen of Wands, the World in Reverse, the Empress, the Nine of Cups, and the Tower. Okay. So from what I'm seeing right now, most of you are enjoying being single with the Nine of Pentacles, focusing on yourself, self-care, self-love, self-admiration. If you're not single, you're simply taking the attention away from your partnership and focusing more on the things that you need to accomplish and your own needs. For some of you, there's something that needs to be taken care of. This is unfinished business with another individual, possibly from the past. Whatever this is, it's keeping you from moving forward. It's keeping the cycle open, and if you want to start something new or start any new projects, it's difficult because, you know, you have some unclosed cycles. You could be dealing with a Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, Taurus, possibly even Gemini. But with the Lovers card, some of you have a choice to make either between two different people or two different paths. If you are a male dealing with two females, I do see a Queen of Wands and an Empress energy. Some of you are dealing with one person that's embodying both of these energies, but let me double check and let's see. Who is the Queen of Wands? Four of Swords, and who is the Empress? Two of Pentacles. So for some of you, this is two people. For one of you, this Empress could be the mother or father of your child, possibly somebody that you wanted to have a new beginning with, but this Empress embodies all four queens within their energy. So this is somebody who's very powerful, someone who's very driven, and I see like this person makes you happy in some type of way. Because of the Empress looking at the Nine of Cups, I feel like someone here views the Empress as wish fulfillment, and you know, they either want to sustain a relationship or pursue the Empress. I feel like you are in some type of standoff with this person. However, with the Five of Wands, this is conflict, drama, fighting, arguments. And with the Two of Pentacles, somebody was juggling, trying to keep their options open. This Empress could have found out and decided to remove themselves from the equation. So that's probably where the unfinished business comes in, because if the Empress left abruptly, then there's definitely some things that need to be discussed, or maybe lack of closure. With the Ten of Cups, there is something that involves a lot of family members in this equation. Some of you are just focused mostly on your emotional fulfillment. Someone here was being selfish. Whoever was being selfish really did not consider the other person's emotions at hand. I feel like the Empress views somebody here as being selfish and really only thinking about themselves and not the other person. So when it comes to this Four of Swords energy, some of you decided to pursue someone new. If you are single and making the decision to pursue someone new, this Queen of Wands is somebody that you view as driven, motivated, a leader, someone that you view as sexy, good-looking, someone that's creative and knows exactly what it is that they want. But the thing is, either this person has retreated from you or vice versa. You have retreated from this person and there's not really any movement forward. And because the Tower is right underneath it, either there's going to have to be some sort of like formal commitment that happens. Because with the Tower underneath, there's something sudden or unexpected that's going to happen that you don't see coming. Whatever this is, it has the potential to come in with destructive energy. And with the Ten of Pentacles, you're going to have to make a decision between long-term and possibly something brand new. But be careful about which choice that you make, because this is ultimately your karma. So you decide which type of karma that you get. If you are committed to one person and you're trying to go towards somebody new or vice versa, someone's committed to you and they're trying to keep their options open, that will come back to you in some type of way. But there is family. Someone here could even possibly be pregnant. So there could be a pregnancy that's affecting the situation as well. But let me get another deck. That way I can get some additional messages. All right. So let's see. Why is the Nine of Pentacles here? Why is the Nine of Pentacles here? Because of the Strength card. Somebody needs to find the strength to hold back, to tame themselves, their inner demons, to tame their impulsiveness. Whoever this is, they have some sort of guide or angel that's guiding them. Some of you could have significance to felines, specifically a lion. But with the Leo card being the strength card here, someone has an option between a strong connection and something divine. So I feel like most of you watching here are going to have a choice in love. If you don't have one right now, it's getting ready to come in. With the Two of Cups, this is a choice between a soulmate and possibly a divine connection, and you're going to have to decide which one you want to go towards. Does this Queen of Wands have good intentions? Six of Swords. Okay, so this Queen of Wands initially may seem like, you know, she's a good match up front. She may seem like she's going to help you move towards peace, but I feel like as the relationship moves forward, this person's going to get you in a position of feeling stuck, feeling like, you know, you're not having any movement forward. And this person is actually going to cause instability in your life rather than stability. And with the Eight of Wands, this person's going to want you to commit to them more than possibly the Empress does, because the Empress seems like she is backing out. Because whoever this Empress is, male or female, they can sense that someone here is trying to keep their options open and they may be committed to you. This person is either choosing not to communicate at this time, and this could possibly be the karma with justice. Because however you treated this person in the past, it's like everything that you did to them, it's not going to come back to you. So if you treated this person with respect and decency, then just know you're going to get that same energy in return. But because the Knight of Swords is in reverse, there could be some drama, some arguments, some fights. With the Ten of Cups being here to the moon, there are some secrets of things that you don't know of that are hidden. Someone could be secretly manipulating you, so you need to be careful with who you have around you. And be careful of manipulating other people, because if you do, what comes for you is the Knight of Pentacles to the Hierophant. So some of you are going to make a sacrifice. Either choose not to be single so that you can move into a formal commitment, while some of you are leaving a commitment behind to decide to be single, and it's not going to work out the same for all of you. When it comes to this Empress, there may be a permanent ending that's coming. Someone here is deciding to do some betrayal, some backstabbing. This Empress has really withstood a lot in this connection with you. I feel like they have been betrayed multiple times in this occasion. So if you're the Empress, you're the person that's been betrayed, stabbed in the back, unappreciated. But if the Empress is the other person you're connected to, I feel like they have been through a lot and they're making the ultimate decision to close out the cycle with you. And if you left this person hanging, you're going to have to go back, whether it's now or later, because the Knight of Pentacles to the Seven of Pentacles, someone here has been investing a lot of time, effort, and dedication into something, and they have not been getting the fruits of their labor, and it's prompting them to go look elsewhere. With the World being here and the Wheel, be careful of how you treat people around this time, because the energy is heavy of karma. Any cycles that you don't close out, or if you have a decision to make between two different paths and you choose to like just stay in a position of indecision, that decision is going to be made for you and you're going to be forced to move forward. And I feel like someone here may end up regretting their decision because of the Queen of Cups. So the person that provided you the most love, nurturing, compassionate energy, this person may choose to go in a different path. Whether it's the Queen of Wands or the Empress in this situation, there is one particular person that has been putting in the dedication and the time and the effort. And if you don't choose this person, they're going to go off on a different path, and look what it's going to leave you with. Regret, remorse, sorrow, sadness, crying over spilled milk, you know, in that grieving energy. So someone here has to make a decision, and you have to do it quickly, because I kind of feel like time is of the essence. Whichever decision that you make is ultimately going to make the decision of how this plays out. So now let's see best advice for my Virgos. Okay, best advice for Virgo. So I got a new deck. It's called the Quantum Tarot deck. Let's see what this entails. Best advice for Virgos. Okay, so we have Nine of Cups, the Lovers, the Infinity, Four of Wands, Three of Wands, Five of Wands. Okay, so you're supposed to choose the person that brings more action into your life, the person that you see the most movement with. If it's a choice or decision that you need to make between two paths, choose the side that's going to bring you happiness with the Nine of Cups. Choose the side that you feel like is going to bring you wish fulfillment, but also choose what you know is divinely sent to you. If you feel like you have to work extremely hard for a relationship, for the most part, it could be that, you know, it's not meant for you. But with the Lovers, one of these paths has been brought to you by the divine, and the other one is something that you're just starting off or something that you want to venture off to. But with the Infinity card being here, just know that everything that you put out will be coming back to you tenfold. And with the Four of Wands, some of you are either moving houses or you're being advised to move somewhere where you have more stability and a foundation. While others of you, there's something that you're waiting on. It could be a job, an offer, whatever this is, it's going to take about 3 weeks to come in. So there is a bit of patience required, but that's not really that much time. With the Five of Wands, be careful of conflict, arguments, putting people in competitive positions. Because like I said, because that's right on top of the Infinity card, it's like if you end up treating someone like, you know, they're nothing, or you just toss them to the side, the person that you choose is going to do the same thing to you. So just be careful how you treat others and put out good energy so it can come right back to you. And like, share, subscribe, leave me a comment. This is the end of your reading, and I hope you have a good day.